really does back up traffic on I-5, so be warned of that, because that is such a popular place.
You know, they have the wine tasting, they have stuff for kids. What a great idea to have.
And it's this year because we've been in spring since January.
I know, no kidding.
It's been so fantastic.
No shocker there that it's opening early. And we're going to continue with the warmer weather, too, so some good news, but I am tracking a little bit of rain. Not right now, 54 degrees right now. And we'll stay dry overnight tonight, too, down into the mid-40s for lows with mostly cloudy skies. And temperatures will continue to drop as we go through the evening, but again, only down into the mid-40s, so not too chilly for you. Here's what it's looking like out there right now, and you can see the clouds pushing on in, and we'll continue to see that rain not far behind, but it is going to hold off for most of our Friday, so I still think we'll get in a lot of dry time tomorrow, especially for the valley and east. Coastal areas, we will start to see that rain move in a little bit sooner. Probably by late morning, you'll start to see those showers, so all coming from this system there that will bring in some wet weather from time to time. So here's how it plays out for you here in Portland. Temperatures in the mid-40s as we go through 7 a.m. Nice and dry, and look at it for most of the first half of the day all the way to 3 p.m. We're just dealing with the gray, but no rain, so looking really, really, really nice there. Outside of a few sprinkles, I think we're looking good. Highs in the low to mid-60s, and then we get to the second half of the day or into the evening, and just in time for that commute home, I'm just going to go ahead and warn you, that's when the showers are going to start to push in, so that can make things a little bit messy, so if you can get out of work a little early, might be a good idea tomorrow. And then temperatures fall to the mid-50s. We'll continue to stay wet overnight tomorrow night, and then it starts to clear out for the second half of Saturday. Now, with this will come some cooler air, too. So Mount Hood Meadows looking nice in the sunshine, but sure would look nicer if we could get some more snow up on top. And there is going to be the potential. We'll have chances tomorrow night, Saturday, and both Monday and Tuesday. Earlier next week looks a little more promising as we tap into some colder air, but at least the tops, you get up above 6,500 feet. And I think by Saturday, we could be looking at 3 to 6 inches, 2 to 5, closer to the base. Going into Monday, Tuesday, maybe up to a foot. Wouldn't that be nice? Here's a look at your 7-day forecast. Temperatures in the low to mid-60s, so dodging showers tomorrow night through the first half of Saturday. And then Sunday, showers don't arrive until Sunday night. So you have all of Sunday pretty much. And then Monday looks a little wet. But again, that'll be one of those days where you're watching the snow come down on the mountains. So some good news there.
And we haven't had it, to say that we're excited about that, because we just haven't seen that many days of snow coming down.
It took spring actually coming for us to get winter weather. How about that this year?
There you go. Thanks, Kristen. Next to